that.
Oh, that's nice, man.
That is a pretty fish.
Look at all that color. Isn't that incredible, really?
Mm-hmm.
Wow. Look at that.
He's pissing out.
You see that? That's disrespectful, eh?
You didn't come all the way to Louisiana.
I should have touched him.
You didn't come all the way to Louisiana to get pissed on, did you?
Yeah. Hey guys and girls, welcome back to our YouTube channel. I've got some big news to share with you as the ink is drying on the agreements, contracts, signatures, execution, whatever you want to call it, for this right here. You see this right here? It's called the Crappie Machine, and it's a rebranded version of our Extreme Crappie Angler, the same series that you loved on linear, which we call at home television. It put us up, I think, in the top four one time for most popular shows on the US networks that we partner with. Now we're going to come back to try to get show number one on the air as soon as we get back on the tube. And when's that going to happen? Well, guess what? COVID tried to knock us down, it couldn't. We're back. We're back with a rebranded crappie show in the same kind of taste that you always enjoyed, man. Road trips with some of the best crappie anglers that we can find. Guys that know the lakes, know the areas, know where to catch them all year long, know what baits to use, know how to adapt. And that's the greatest thing about our series. We fish with guys that know how to find and catch big crappie. And with the Crappie Machine, we're only going to fish during peak times because you want to catch big crappie, right? I love big, huge, white and black crappie. There's enough small crappie stuff on the internet. I don't want to watch it anymore. I don't think you do either. You want to find out how to catch the big, fat slabs. When should I go? Who should I fish with? We've got all that arranged. There's only a few spots left with different guys in different locations across the US of A. So for watching our video, at the end here, please comment. I've got an official Crappie Machine swag long sleeve tee, and I've got our flex fit cap. Do you want one? All you gotta do is like the video, subscribe to our channel, and post some comments. That's it. I'm going to show you, you know, a couple road trip examples. I wanted to really celebrate what we did in the past and just share some of the experiences we had on some of these road trips with some phenomenal crappie fishermen. And I mean, beautiful places to go, great experiences, fantastic food from catfish, crappie, you name it, man. We did it all. And we are coming back to rock the pond for the crappie world. So in the first part, I want to share the very first time, man, I fished in the land of the giants. And you know where that is. If you love crappie, you know it. It's Mississippi, Grenada Lake. I thought I was Mr. Know-It-All. You know what? Seriously, I got in a small 12-foot flat-bottom jumbo boat with a couple cane polers that knew how to kick this guy's butt. And they did. They showed me. You ever fished cane pole before? I thought I did. Now I do because of guys like this right here. Check it out. Grenada Lake, Mississippi, catching big whites like this. Cane pulling, John boat, and we're gonna have a blast. Let's see if we can get some good ones like this, right on this one and that one. Wow.
These are probably post-spawn crappie that we're catching. We're just off of the Schooner River, and all of this is pretty flat across here, but it's not far from the edge of the river. What we have here is a flat, and it's got little low spots in the flat that held moisture, and that's why these weeds came up. So it's a little shallower on the outer edge of the weeds, and that's where the fish seem to be, most of the fish seem to be.
We'll show you this about how many years ago.
Oh, we've been fishing down here a long time. And like I said, in our earlier years, we fished Enid more than Grenada. But probably the last 20 years or so, we fished Grenada a lot more than Enid.
Right. You know what's cool about this is I'm always in a bass boat or some other trolling boat in Lake Ontario, whatever it's for salmon or trout. Fishing like this,
People might think it's just an easy thing, but it is an art to catch them consistently and big. Oh, look at that.
Oh, man, that's a good fish.
Nice one. Oh, wow.
Catch of the day there.
Look at that. That is psychotic. Look at that. Look, that is one scary crappie. Look at that. Wow, man.
That's a female that's already laid.
Wow.
That fish would have probably gone 2.5 pounds full of eggs.
Wow.
The crappie have to be 12 inches. And that's recently changed. It was 10. And they felt like there was decline in the fish population and size. So they increased it to 12. Earlier this year, when probably in the prime of the spawn, we caught some real good fish. The people who troll deeper water will catch 3-pound crappie. They had a recent tournament down here, I think it was the last weekend or weekend before last, 7-fish limit, total of 19 pounds and 6 ounces, almost a 3-pound average.
He's got this rigged where he'll show me, I use a bright line, he's got it set. It's locked on the reel and just vertically up and down. No fancy jigging, nothing. Like a big crappie right
there.
Yes,
sir. There you go.
Look at that, boy. Swing him in there. Look at that, it's a good net, man. Jerry. Wow, man. Awesome. Look at that. Now there's my first Mississippi white crappie. Ooh. Look at the yap on him. Holy cow. Thank you, sir. Boy, look how far down they take that. Whites. Fat too. Got a big back on them. Big eyes.
Yeah,
look at the fins on them, eh? Beautiful looking fish.
Yeah.
Right?
The fish on Grenada normally are thicker than on most of the other lakes. Just heavier fish.
Gotcha.
You think you could get used to this crappie fishing?
Oh, are you kidding? Awesome, man. Once you figure out this stuff, I'd get a little John boat. Have some fun, boy. Ooh, boy. This world.
Water's about 4.5 feet deep here, and we're going all the way down to the bottom and then just kind of bouncing off the bottom. There's a lot of weeds that have kind of laid down in the water, under the water, and the fish like to get on top of those. Close to 14-inch fish, 13.5.
There's a nice one right there. Whoa, boy. Look at him go. He's scrapping around. Oh, Bill's grabbing the net. And there he is. Ooh, nice one.
And man, no road trip is complete without experiencing some of the culinary cuisine. And Mississippi has got so much opportunities for Southern food flair. So think about this right here. Some frog legs, some catfish. You want it? You got it.
When we're in Grenada, Mississippi, you know we're gonna be having a meal at the 333 restaurant for some of those golden brown catfish.
From the buffet, you would have at least two different types of catfish. You have a whole catfish, a slice. And once we get finished with that, we go to the shrimp and then the frog legs. But most time, before we do the shrimp, we always do the frog legs because sometimes it take a little bit more time. Because since the shrimp, they always have to be battered.
Our catfish is sliced, which means it's cut in individual pieces. And our whole fish is going to be soaked to the bottom. And when it gets done, it's going to raise up to the top and turn to a dark brown. But you don't want it to be too soft. You want it to be real nice and crispy so it still bring out the flavor. Always let them always stay in here a little while longer because most times since it's in a boil, it's not going to be all the way hard like everybody likes it. So I let it sit in like two more minutes extra, and that'll come out to it, be a bright yellow. You always have up to 26 strips of slices for your first batch, but once you do your first batch, you don't intentionally have to make that many. You just wait till your next order. Now your whole catfish that's at the bottom, it always take a little while longer because the meat in the inside has to make sure it be well done. And the fish is starting to come up, so it's about time for me to bring those up. And that's how they're gonna look.
You see what I mean? You talk about good times, boy. Good times and old myths. And I remember my very first time going to Louisiana, hooking up with the famous guys from the Duck Dynasty fame, from Duck Commander, John Godwin, Jay Stone. And I got to fish with Jay first, man. And I tell you, what an experience fishing on Lake Darbonne. Nobody before us ever was on Lake Darbonne. No tournaments, no TV shows, thanks to some invitations we had. Friend, I'll give you a heads up. Brandon Jennings, he was a guy who stepped up and made all this happen. And now everybody knows about Darbonne because of that boy. But when I fished with Jay, and he spider rigged, and he showed me big jigs, big baits, big minnows. You know why? Because he knows how to catch big crappie. And that's the thing about this series moving forward. We're going to fish with guys that show you maybe conventional and unconventional ways to catch bigger than average crappie. You want small crappie? Do whatever you want. We want to catch the great big giants. Some we keep, some we let go, respect the resource, but to each their own. So on this first part, I fished with Jay Stone, Lake Darbonne, Louisiana, pushing minnows and grubs with the spider rig. Check this out, because man oh man, it was exciting for me, and I know it will be for you too.
And you know it from Duck Commander, who knows how to catch crappie.
So Jack Wells from B&M called me up. He said, look here, man. I got a guy who has a fishing show up in Canada called Crappie Kings. And I've seen it before, because you know, all crappie fishermen, we're all scanning the channels trying to find a crappie show, which there's not many of, and thank goodness we have one now. And he says, look, man, I told this guy that you would be able to put them on big crappie, no doubt in my mind, so no pressure. He's coming tomorrow.
Hey, talk about exciting. I got a chance on Crappie Kings to fish with Jay Duckman Stone. When I heard through the grapevine, he's a good crappie fisherman. So was I excited? You bet.
Just 10 miles east of us, where I live, we have the Washita River, which is where we do most of our duck hunting.
Yeah.
And that's some good fishing over there too. We fish a lot of tops.
Oh wow.
The single pole on those tops, those big blacks get in there knock the fish.
So you got blacks and whites.
Oh yeah.
Nice.
We'll catch, you know, 9-1 whites.
All right, we get down to the ramp. Jay's got this big bay boat. He said, don't be surprised, but you know what? It's great. It's laid out perfect for the crappie fisherman. Lots of room. He's got the deck. He's got the seats. He's got the spider rigs. Lots of rods. Very impressive.
Here's what we got. We have a sandbar out in the dead middle of this big pocket. And not many people know that these fish spawn on this thing. Big fish. So this is I guess you could call it a secret hole.
Yeah.
One of them, you know what I'm talking
about.
So
they're going to see it on TV, but
they're
going to
see it on
location.
TV. That's right. They'll look around and they say, oh, I know where that's at. No, they don't know where it's at. So we ain't got to worry about that. But what we're going to do is we're going to fish about 2-3 foot deep. It's going to be about 6 to 8 foot of water.
Okay.
And we're going to be fishing along the edge of this contour line, right on the drop off of that sandbar. And hopefully we'll find some of those big males guarding those beds over there. That's the game plan.
I'm set.
All right, I think we're ready.
Yep.
Let's go get on our contour line.
Okay.
Try to find some of these big old crappies. We start fishing. You know, I'm following contour lines that I've marked on previous trips. And it was slow at first, but I knew that if we ever found a few fish here, that they would be really good ones. I don't know if you noticed on these double jig rigs, I have 2/4 ounce jig heads.
Yeah, I've seen them good size.
And the main reason for that is I want to keep these lines as vertical as possible.
Mm-hmm.
Even going, you know, 0.3, 0.4, you know, they're still pretty vertical.
This is going to get nasty.
There he is.
Oh you mama! Heads. Wow!
Kidding me?
This is just all right.
that elusive Lake Darbone crappie.
He's back on it. Watch him. Watch him close. There he is.
I got you.
You've been there, Kansas.
Oh my God, that was a good one too. Oh God.
You got a minute?
Buddy, oh, you're right, Jay. He came right back. Oh, he was a nice one too, wasn't he?
Oh yeah, good fish.
Oh God. These guys have been playing possum with me. We have good quality fish, we have lots of fish, but they're not those real big giants. So we get to the first spot, Jay lays out the spider rigs, and I'm thinking, okay, let's see. What happens? I lose the first fish, and it's a hubcap.
Now this is kind of like that big bass hole. You know, you might fish all day and just get a few bites, but when you get one, it's gonna be a stud. I noticed you boys from Canada, you're a little bit slow on the draw, and a little scared to set the hook too. I said, don't be scared to cross his eyes. So we eased along that contour, and all of a sudden, old Carl finally lit into one, and from then on, it was on like Donkey Kong.
Not that time, you.
Get the net, Ken. Drop it.
Oh, that's a big one, too.
Get the net. There we go. That's what we're talking
about. Oh, man, he buried it.
That's that big sow we've been looking for.
Yeah, boy, oh, boy.
Good
buried
work,
it.
You know, Kansas got them cat-like reflexes, you know.
That's yes, sir.
That's why I carry.
Look at the mouth on that thing. Oh, yeah. Gee, I'm impressed, man. That is something else. I'll give you the rod. That'd be all right. Thanks, buddy. Well, look at that. See that? Lake Darbone. Seriously, big, thick, chunky, crappy, man. These are impressive. You're right. You're on the stud spot.
You don't have look at that, eh? Mississippi
no, studs. Man. Like, to me, they remind me of saltwater fish, too, with the big fins and everything. Gives them all that power, eh?
Oh, yeah.
Look at that, like a smallmouth bass. Wow. Impressive. Darbone. First, but not the last, eh, buddy?
Not hardly.
Hey, you know one of the most exciting things about this series, about shooting that earlier and now getting back right into it again, like jumping right back into the pond with 2 feet, 2 hands, 2 jig poles? It is fishing with some of the most incredible crappie fishermen on planet Earth. And Jay showed me back then that the small little things that make a big difference in spider rigging. You think you just put out the poles, get out there, and just cover the lake. No, man. Speed, temperature, water clarity, time of year, bait sizes, bait colors, minnows, you name it, man. It's a science. It really is a science. It's not fluke. And that's why this series helps you find and catch some of the biggest crappie of your life. Because of guys like this right here, Jay Stone and his spider rig crappie.
Where's that net, buddy? Oh, watch that. Look at him go. Where are you? Come on, Kansas. Come on, buddy. Lean, buddy, lean. You got him.
Good work, Kansas.
I watch that fish pulling all over the place. They're kissing it first, eh? And then, whoa.
So now I'm excited. The right speed, the right depth, the right colors, and bang, 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 starting to catch some nice quality crappie.
You don't want to go on a hook. Now, there are some of my better bites today. Big jig, quarter ounce jig head, big minnow. Look at the size of that presentation. You think, oh, too big for crappie? Sorry, folks, we're fishing Lake Darbone for big crappie. It don't matter to them. The big ones are eating it. Big ones want it.
Oh. Big female. Oh, that's big male. Big male.
Big dark one, huh? See that? That's excitement again. I should have went like this. See that, folks? I'm doing it now. Look. you wait for the bite, and then it goes. Like, really, can't get any better when you think about it. Look, sets up the bait, takes the hooks off, and I just got to stand and wait, you know?
You don't even.
How's it looking?
Carl, you don't have to stand.
Want me to help you? That's true. Why am I standing?
Why are you standing?
Black slab. Look at him. He's got his warrior colors on for a lot of reasons. That's my belief. He wants to meet with that beautiful female. And I think he's trying to intimidate the other ones. Look at me. I'm big. I'm mean. But you know where you're going? Into the hurt locker, boy.
In this scenario, when we're pushing jigs over a pretty vast amount of water, we're covering a lot of water. I want to get big baits on and cover a lot of area.
Look at this, see?
Go ahead and catch yours while you're adjusting it.
Yes. Oh, that's on rod one too, isn't it?
I got it. Let go of it.
Just kissed it on the side, huh? Good stuff, Jay.
There you go.
Good stuff. You're eating it for the camera. Look at that. My shot's there. Oh, yeah.
Pretty male.
Yes. So, he hasn't got his war colors yet.
All right, what's a day with crappie fishing without having some phenomenal meals? And Jay was nice enough to share his Japanese crispy crappie recipe that has just rocked the internet. The way it tastes, the way he prepared it, the way it looked. Trust me when I tell you, this next recipe was so famous, we were just besieged with emails and messages and stuff. We will post it moving forward as well too, wherever we are, whoever we fish with, how they prepare their crappie a certain ways, whether it be catfish, I don't care. You just want to enjoy the fruits of your labor after a great day of fishing, and we did too on Door Bone, just like this right here with Mr. Jay Stone.
Crappie recipe we're going to do this evening is what we like to call spicy Japanese crispy crappie. Get them all in the bottom of your bowl. I'm gonna kind of spread these out a little bit. And this next step is the most important one, because the idea is, you know, since we're fixing to use panko breadcrumbs, which are dry, crunchy breadcrumbs, they have to stick to that fillet. And in order for that to stick, we're just gonna pat dry all these fillets in the bottom of that bowl. We want them nice and sticky. We'll move them around, get all the water out. No water. And this is a good step for any kind of frying. If you're using any kind of batter whatsoever, this is a really good thing to do. We're gonna break out the black pepper, and we're not gonna use it sparingly. Heavy, heavy, heavy on the black pepper. Now you're probably saying, why in the world would you put that much black pepper on there? It's because when I put my egg wash on, and once I mix them all up, get that egg wash on them real good and thick, most of that black pepper isn't gonna be there. We're gonna start out with one egg. What this egg wash does, it helps these panko crumbs to stick to that crappie. Without this, it will not stick. They will fall off, so you must use the egg wash. We're gonna get that egg wash all over those fish, like so. Kind of just get a feel for it, just kind of mix it around. All right, the next thing we're gonna do, we're gonna take our panko breadcrumbs. Now, and this is the case for all types of frying. You don't wanna put your flour, cornmeal, breadcrumbs, whatever you're frying with, wait till the last minute to put that on those fish, and they'll fry up a lot lighter and crispier. So we got us a pan full of panko. And now, we're gonna head to the fryer. So all we're gonna do is we're just gonna roll it in them pankos. And if you got a basket fryer, don't lay them in the bottom of the basket. Drop them straight in the grease, that way they won't stick together. And this ain't gonna take but about 3 minutes. And they will be done. As soon as you take them out of the grease, as soon as you take them out, go ahead and dust them with that essence. While that grease is still wet on there, that seasoning stick a lot better. Fish dip. We're gonna start out with mayonnaise. You say, how much? I say, you got a bunch of fat boys standing around you, a bunch of it. Horseradish sauce. You say, how much horseradish sauce you put in there? Well, that's according to how much you like horseradish. If you like horseradish, put a bunch of it in there. Dijon mustard, lemon juice, not much. A little Worcestershire. Whatever kind of seasoning you like. Old Bay blackened seasoning. I'm gonna go heavy, heavy, heavy on that. We're just gonna stir it all up. Should get a light brown texture here, or color. You could add relish to it if you want it to be more like a tartar sauce, but I like a little creamy dipping sauce. All right, let's see what we got. Yep, we're good. And this is what we call our Japanese style crappie with our world famous fish dip. Hope you enjoy it. What about it?
You know, I thought that was great. It is. It just makes it phenomenal.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, you talk about phenomenal experiences. It's never just easy. You know what I mean? Going back into a slough, or they call up Carl and say, Carl, get down here. The crappie are all bundled up and waiting for you. But we did have a scenario like that the very first time in Mississippi on Lake Washington with my buddy Tim Blackley. The week before, early March, the guys were pounding before a tournament. Everybody's recording 3-pound fish. You know, the lake really wasn't on the map back then. But Tim says, hey, get down there. It's not just Grenada, Sardis, Enid, Arca Butler. There's another lake here called Lake Washington. So we went over to Bait and Things. We hooked up with Mike there too. And he showed us a few things to help us get customized or get acclimatized, I guess, to the areas where we're going to fish. I get there, it's just as cold as Canada in early March. Tim proved the versatility, the way these guys adapt. I mean, they are like the Marines of fishing. They adapt, overcome, improvise. Tim did that so I could have the experience the first time on Lake Washington to catch some big, beautiful white crappie and lead to new trips with him on that fantastic lake called Washington.
It's foggy. It's cold, but I want to catch crappie.
You know, Carl called. He's wanting to come south, get out of that cold up in Canada. I picked him up in Memphis, headed to Lake Washington in Mississippi. We met some more cold weather down there. We got there, temperatures were cold. We were bundled up, wearing gloves, hats, toboggans.
It's 32 degrees right now this morning. We're going to start out fishing about 30 inches deep, probably 6 or 8 foot of water.
First week of March, usually by now it's 60, 70 degrees, beautiful sun, you name it. Week before, the guys are just smashing crappie. I get here, it's jacket, insulated pants, long underwear, gloves all day. What's up with that?
Water temperature is 45 degrees. A week ago we was here, it was 55. So, you know, it's putting them in a holding pattern. They should be out here in a little bit deeper water, so that's where we're gonna give them a try. And hopefully have a good day.
Now, you know Tim knows how to find crappie. It doesn't matter where it is in the United States. So I'm relying on him. Remember, I'm the co-captain. I'm watching the rods, making sure the line's not jumping up, going to the right, going to the left.
Today we're gonna use B&M Captain Coleman Minnow Rigs, and we're gonna mix it up with some Strike King tubes and maybe some Rage Tail grubs on some 1/8 ounce and 1/4 ounce jig heads, just to try to find out what the bite is, what they're looking for, if they're wanting something a little bit smaller like a minnow or something larger. Take us a couple hours to figure that out. Once we get dialed in, we'll probably switch all to one bait, either minnows or jigs. So we'll see how that goes.
Netter, Tim?
Yeah.
Atta boy, Tim. Lake Washington crappie. Well, that's a nice one, eh?
Big white, big female.
First Lake Washington fish, Tim. What do you think of that?
2-pound fish.
First live well fish of the day?
Yeah, that's
good. Can I hold it?
Nice fish.
You see what a nice guy? He lets me hold it. He caught it. First Lake Washington crappie of the year. In a box. Fat-bellied crappie. Come on.
You know, at these lakes, especially down in Mississippi, for some reason these fish position themselves up high in the water column. We see it all the time. You know, it might be 10 foot deep. We might just be fishing 12 inches on the surface. Fish are like us. They want to be comfortable. They want to be able to breathe. And they want to be where they can get something to eat.
Oh, geez. And I got this going here. Sorry, Tim.
You better grab a net.
Where are you, Tip? Where's the net? Oh, God. He's heavy. Attaboy. Attaboy, Tim.
Got him on that old Strike King 2. Red chartreuse. Look what a belly. That's a fat bottom girl there. Old fat bottom girl.
We just moved too, eh?
Pretty fish.
Yeah, man. I'm going to do the honors. You see? You fish with the right guy, you get to hold a fish too. But I promise you, sooner or later, that's going to happen. Look how thick. Look at that. Wow. We're going to let her go. We're going to take some pictures of some of these fish. Look at the backs too, how nice and thick. Just a gorgeous fish. Gorgeous fish. Got a little scar on her. We're going to put her in a live well and let her go in a bit. Thank you, big girl. Making our day. The sun finally comes out, but it's still cold. And we're wondering, are they going to bite? They start biting.
Oh, looky here, baby. On a G.
Left him in, all right?
Bring him on in. Looky here.
Whoa.
Oh, come over here, brother.
You see, swing and a miss, huh? I didn't miss that one. I mean, is that the same one?
Yep.
Same one came back.
Same one on the other pole.
Grabbed. Hit my little B&M one. He just a small one. But a little female, maybe, hey?
Yeah, female.
Little female. Going back. You know what that is? My first Washington crappie that I caught. 2014. God, I love you, crappie. You ready to go back? Huh? Ready to go back? Tell Mama to come on over, bite the left side of the boat, okay? Go on. Bye.
Man, let me share with you the experiences, some of the things that I've had with these guys that I fish with, okay? You can be humbled real quick in fishing when you think you know it all. And that's one thing I'd like to take pride in. I've always kept an open mind. I don't care what I'm fishing for. Trout, walleye, northern pike, bass, you name it. But when these guys showed me there's so many different aspects of crappie fishing on the different lakes, different conditions, the different times of the year, how they do it, why they do it. I mean, one good thing that can happen is you get better at it. So this series, The Crappie Machine, is going to go, information overload. Easy to understand how they do it. Showing this guy here, because man, most of the times I'm just a co-pilot, okay? I've learned enough techniques with these guys, but I do not profess to be as good as them. We're helping showcase what they help to provide for you, either by guiding or just experience, because their papa did it, their grandfather did it, and now they do it, man. And we're going to share it with you on how to do it. Be versatile, what to use on so many different bodies of water. I guarantee you, you're going to enjoy it.
You know, under cold conditions, we had to alternate our pattern from what we normally do. We're normally trolling pretty fast. We had to slow our presentation down. You know, we had to actually get down to a slow grind and position our baits at different depths. Not real deep, but we had some maybe 30 inches on the surface and some 12 inches on the surface.
There's a lot of things in fishing that excite me. When we start catching big, fat slab crappie, the whole world stops for me, because all I'm looking at is that rod. Is it going to bounce? Is it going to the left? Going to go to the right? Is it going to come up? Everything else stops. All I'm looking at is that pole and a big crappie. Looks like a good one. Looks like a good one. Attaboy, Blackley. Thank you, sir.
Look at him go. Again, old Strike King jig. They won't bite you.
Yes, sir. Bite you. Look at that, eh? Crappie. White crappie. Oh, he's got it, too. Just right through the jig, around the glove, in the glove. Talk about pandemonium. That's what you got right there. Look at that. Beautiful. Beautiful. Pearl. Beautiful. Cold water crappie. Gonna go in the live well with the other couple we got. We'll let them go, take some pictures. But some of these be good for eating. You know, they're not full of eggs. We'll have a little fish fry. Let's put her in there. Ready to go in there? Your friends are waiting. You want to go in? I like the way she drunk it like that. You can still see a little mark on her hook. The hook went in. Bang! Those are the bites you like. one, because those are the bites you rarely miss. Even if I didn't see the bite, Tim, get him! Boom, he got it good. So maybe that sun just inspired them a little bit more, and just trigger effect to start biting more so we can catch him. So next time you come to Lake Washington, you are gonna catch him. Little Rosie, oh, fingers are just froze. That little minnow, barely through the lips. Look how small that is. You gonna catch me a big fish or a small fish? As long as it's any fish. Let's see. Double minnow rig, jig. Which one's gonna get bit? Jig's been hot, eh?
What's today?
Attaboy, Tim. Attaboy, Tim.
Jig fell out in the net.
Did it?
Yep.
Oh boy. Whoo, lordy. That's why we come to Lake Washington, huh?
Strike King strikes again.
That's the deal today. Look at that thing. Look at those fins, eh? I said it before, I say it again. Just look at that fins, man. That's where all that power is when we're swimming. Everywhere, boy. The back, big yap. Well, she's gonna join her friends for a short swim, for some pictures. You made it on TV. You're on Crappie King's television, girl. Thank you, making our day. Well, as you can see, we're not catching a lot, and it's water's only like 47 degrees, but the sun's come out, we're warming up a bit, and the biggest thing with this really is focus and concentration still, and not just saying, well, bite's off, we're not getting any, go in. Tim perseveres, moves around different spots. You know, if you don't get him in 8-9 feet, moving into 7. He made a comment that if we don't get him in this 9, we're gonna go a little bit deeper and try. But different depths, alter it, adapt, and you'll catch him. Like us on Washington or anywhere else, crappie swim in a cold front. Let's keep going, hopefully we get some more.
You know, we've altered our pattern. Finally, we're catching some good sized fish and 2+ pounds. That's what Lake Washington is known for. And that's what we started catching.
Wind just changed direction.
Uh-huh.
Maybe I'll make them bite.
God, no. God, what a monster crappie, boys and girls. That dude hit like he weighed 15 pounds. Oh, man. What a hit! Oh, he ain't that.
Your rod scream?
He ain't no giant, but my goodness, he was mad.
Oh, you good fish, man. Good fish, Tim.
Another 2+.
In the box?
2+.
Not a bad average, huh? Beautiful fish. Put him in there, keep going. Looking for more and more. Average like that, boy. Anywhere across the states, it's pretty good fishing. Even when it's slow. Ready?
The Fat Baby Catfish House. How can you not like that name? Really, this guy is like the connoisseur of catfish. He knew the different ways to cook it, whole, fillet, you name it, man. This place was a joy. Again in Mississippi, eating right, eating fun, and having the time of my life filming crappie, but again, eating some fantastic Southern specialties.
I'm Joey Tatum. I'm the owner of Fat Baby's Catfish House in Cleveland, Mississippi. We've been in business a little over 10 years now. Started in January of 2004. We have steaks, seafood. We have fried shrimp, boiled shrimp, catfish. We also grill and blacken catfish. Our catfish is all U.S. farm-raised catfish. Comes from a local plant here in Edobina, America's Catch. The whole catfish is pretty popular. A lot of people like the bone cooked in the fish. It gives it a lot better flavor. Okay. It's kind of like steak. A lot of people prefer T-bone or porterhouse over a ribeye. The bone makes it taste better. 7 days a week, 11 to 2:30 for lunch, and 4:30 to 10 for dinner. I'm gonna show y'all how to cook some southern fried catfish. These fillets are already prepped and ready to fry. We split them. We take a whole fillet and split it in half. when we fry them, they fry up a lot crispier and cook a little faster. It's a cornmeal breading that we mix up ourselves, our own special seasonings. We make our own hush puppies. Our mix is already made up here. Fresh cut French fries. And here's the reason you should come to Fat Baby's Catfish House.
Well, there you have it. Volume one in the books, okay? Crappie Road Trips. I got two more volumes to show you to hopefully inspire you for this new series, Crappie Machine. Now remember, if you want to earn or win this free long sleeve shirt, you want to win this flex fit cap, all you got to do is like the video, maybe share the video on your social media platforms, post, but please, man, subscribe to our channel, okay? Everybody's got to eat, okay? But think about what's coming, the Crappie Machine. We're going to have online stores, shirts, hats, hoodies, you name it, stickers, boat decals, truck decals, everything you want will be available from the Crappie Machine. We're about to turn the buttons up, push all the buttons and make the machine go, because baby, we's coming back to rock the ponds. Thanks for watching. Subscribe to our YouTube channel and like us on all our pages dedicated to crappie in the links below in the description section of this video.